everybody. Welcome to the Millionaire Hot Seat. Let's give away $1 million tonight to one of these six contestants. I want somebody to win big money, take it home, change your life for the better, just as we have by coming up here to Queensland. It's been fantastic. We'd like to thank the Queensland Government for all their support. Screen Queensland have been sensational. Gold Coast City Council, Tourism and Events Queensland, and the mighty Star, the Star where we've been staying, has been absolutely fantastic. What a great place to have a holiday. And speaking of stars, let's meet the stars of our show tonight. They are our contestants, and in seat number one, right there, we've got Bree Squires, was the first person to ride three-time Melbourne Cup winner, Maccabi Diva. Holly Peters won $1,000 worth of dentistry training for brushing her cat's teeth. Simon Fallon was the third highest winning contestant ever on Sale of the Century. In Canada, Alison Jack was forced to sleep under a tree in the snow. Senior investigator for Queensland Police, Nick Williams, tells people he's an accountant. And Adam Spies took his wife on a romantic first date to a pub to eat pizza and watch the Brisbane Broncos. Yeah. Yeah. You old romantic, you, hey? All right, we're going to play 15 questions for fastest finger first, then 15 more when we get to the hot seat. $1,000 for the first 15, which is also a lifeline, which you can use then, hopefully, to win $1 million or a whole lot of cash. That's what we're going to do. This is called fastest finger first. Let's go. Heads down, everybody. 15 questions coming your way. Here it is. Which of these is not the name of a character in the X-Men film franchise? A, Rogue, B, Cyclops, C, Wolverine, D, Captain Underpants. Not the name. I got a funny feeling Captain Underpants isn't the name. What do you reckon? Is that right? Yeah. These people got it right. Everybody got it. Adam was the fastest. 1.96. Good stuff, Adam. Okay, let's go. Question two. The harpsichord is an instrument that most closely resembles which of these? A, trumpet, B, piano, C, double bass, D, clarinet. The harpsichord. The harpsichord is closest to a piano. These people got it. Simon was the fastest. Simon, well played. The keyboard, like a piano, but instead of being hit with hammers, when the keys are pressed, the strings are plucked. Okay. Question three. Since 2012, Finnish passports have had a flipbook feature that shows a walking what? A, fox, B, hedgehog, C, moose, D, penguin. Answer is a moose. These people got it. Bree was the only one. Good on you, Bree. Well played. Let's go. Next question. It's a visual one. Everybody, have a look at the monitors up around the studio. Having a good look there. Here's the question. What type of flower is this? A, dahlia, B, lily, C, peony, D, tulip. It is my wife's favourite flower. It is a peony. These people got it. Holly was the fastest. Bree got it right. She leads by one from Alison, who also got it right. We thought it'd be around 30 species of peony, or peony roses as they're also known. Okay. Question five. Which of these words is not synonymous with theft? A, perjury, B, robbery, C, pilferage, D, larceny. Which is not associated with theft? The answer is A, perjury. These people got it. Nick was the fastest. Going, Nick. Good stuff. Everyone got it right except for Alison. Bree leads by two. Question six. She's 5 from 5. Pope Francis was born in 1936 in which country? A, Italy, B, Portugal, C, Mexico, D, Argentina. Pope Francis is from Argentina. These people got it right. Simon and Nick, good on you, Simon and Nick. The only Catholics amongst us, are we? There we go. Let's move on now to question seven. Travelling between the cities of Rockhampton and Brisbane is the rail service called the What Train? A, twisting, B, tilt, C, trackless, D, toot, toot. Between Rocky and Brisbane, we have the tilt train. Just some of the famous and different things you'll see here. It's electric train service, which began in 98, travelling from the southern and central coast of Queensland, connecting the key cities. These people got it. Nick was the fastest. Got a Nick to a 0.93 of a second. Let's go to the leaderboard after the first seven questions. And Bree is 6 out of 7. Well played. Simon and Nick on 5. Alison 4. Holly and Adam on 3. Plenty of chances for everybody to win the lifeline right after this in Fastest Finger First. If you're dreaming of the perfect holiday destination, packed with adventure and idyllic escape from every day, Queensland is ready to welcome you when the time is right. With more than 6,000 kilometres of coastline to explore, there's no shortage of tranquil spots to place your beach towel. Here, you can sink your feet into the powder white sand, wade into the warm waves and discover the natural wonder of the Great Barrier Reef. Come and experience the beauty of Queensland one day soon.
This program is brought to you by Barnacle Bill. Come and celebrate 50 years of serving quality seafood to South Australians.
Welcome back to the Hot Seat. Let's get cracking and good luck, because Bree is leading at the moment by 1 from Simon and Nick, but everyone else is pretty close. So let's get into it. A person who is a joiner predominantly works with which material? A, metal, B, clay, C, wood, D, stone. The answer is C, wood. These people got it. Everyone bar Nick. Adam was the fastest. Got the Adam well played. Question number. In Australia, which of these retailers is affiliated with the fuel brand Mobil? A, Coles, B, 7-Eleven, C, Woolworths, D, Kmart. Mobil. Answer is 7-Eleven. These people got it. Bree was the fastest and leads by 1.84 seconds. Well played, Bree. Here's question 10. Officially worn by Australian Test cricketers, what is the baggy green? A, cap, B, vest, C, apron, D, backpack. What is the baggy green? That is the famous Australian cricket cap. These people got it. Everyone, and Simon is the fastest. Going, Simon, well played. Trails Bree by 1. Here's an audio question. Let me give you the question. Listen for the clue. Here it comes. Released as a single in 1994, this song is by which band? A, Alice in Chains, B, Nirvana, C, Pearl Jam, D, Soundgarden. ''94, it is, of course, Nirvana. These people got it. Nick was the fastest. Going to Nick, 0.78 of a second, bounces back. Bree was sharp as well. Let's have a quick look at the leaderboard. Bree leads by 1 from Simon on 9, Nick on 8, Adam on 7, and Alison and Holly are 4 behind and can still win from here. Let's go. Something required by etiquette or current fashion is described by which of these common French phrases? A, fait accompli, D, B, de rigueur, C, joie de vivre, and D, eau de toilette. The answer is de rigueur. These people got it. In strictness is what the literal meaning is. Simon jumps up to equal lead. There you go. Nick gets up there, 1 behind. It is tight at the top. Let's go. The 2001 film Jurassic Park 3 stars which of these actors? A, Richard Attenborough, B, Julianne Moore, C, Bryce Dallas Howard, D, Taya Leone. Answer is Taya Leone. These people got it. Oh, Bree's fought back beautifully. Adam was the fastest. Bree got it right, and she moves one clear. Okay, two left. Bree leads by one. Simon and Nick are still in it. Adam and Alison and Holly, you're playing for the love of the game. Good luck. Which animal is depicted on the Australian 5-cent coin? A, lyrebird, B, platypus, C, possum, D, echidna. We need the echidna. Who got it? Oh, Bree was the fastest, 0.7 of a second. That's good playing, Bree. Here we go, last question. Bree, get it right, you're home. Which of these planets in the solar system is farthest from the sun? A, Mars, B, Earth, C, Mercury, D, Venus. Furthest from the sun. The answer is Mars. Oh, I don't like the look of that, Bree. Those who got it right are Holly in seat two is the quickest. Simon got it. So it's 12 apiece for Bree and Simon. And the fastest finger means that Simon gets up on the line and wins the $1,000. Congratulations, Simon. Well done, buddy.
Thank you, Eddie.
Frank. Well done, mate. Congratulations. You've got your $1,000. What are you going to do with that?
More toys, Eddie.
More toys.
I want to upgrade my drone.
Oh, yeah? What do you do with your drone?
Photographs of Brisbane River and cruise ships coming in. When they used to come in,
exactly.
Yeah, that's right.
Good on you, mate. Well, don't screw it up too much because you might give it back to me,
I'll
okay?
Just pop it in there.
We'll get back after this. Bree, so close.
Story of my life.
Hey, come back after this and win $1 million. That's all you need to do. The person who first rode Maccabi Diva knows what a champion has to do on the big day. She's next in the hot seat to play for $1 million right after this. Millionaire Hot Seat is brought to you by The Star Gold Coast. This luxurious resort has some of Australia's finest accommodation, restaurants and entertainment, all in a beautiful tropical setting where every guest is treated like a millionaire. Whether you're into luxury, fine dining, relaxing by the pool or enjoying the nightlife, The Star Gold Coast is your answer. Head to thestargoldcoast.com.au for details and bookings. So, are you in? Fantastic. Fastest finger first. Well done to Simon. He got up on the line, just knocked over Bree, but it doesn't matter. That was the barrier trial. This is the main event, OK? Ready? Let's go. Come on, Bree. All the racing metaphors there because she's a retired professional jockey. These days working as a correctional officer.
Yeah.
How's that going?
Yeah, it's all right.
Good stuff. Now, tell me about the jockey days.
I used to work for the great Greg Bennett.
Yep.
Who's now based in Queensland as well. And we had the pleasure of breaking in Maccabi Diva.
Yeah, now tell me about Maccabi Diva.
I think Benno was quoted, or Greg, Benno as everyone knows him, was quoted in the Herald as saying that you could drink a cup of tea on her back and roll a smoke and she wouldn't even break a sweat.
Yeah, so just balanced stride and everything going.
And massive lungs.
What was it like to ride her at that early stage?
She was great.
Yeah?
Absolutely great.
Now, tell me about this. You studied law while you were riding to prepare for life after being a jockey.
Yep.
After 5 years into your degree, you had a racing fall and you lost your memory.
Yes. I was so close to finishing my degree and I'm still paying for my degree.
Yeah, your hex fees.
Well, I'd love to win some money.
How bad was the fall?
It was pretty bad. Three of us came down and I broke my back, my pelvis, ribs, collarbones.
Gosh, yep. When you see a race fall, there's nothing more, I think, frightening than watching the jockeys come down in a race fall.
We know it's part of the package. It's the only job where an ambulance follows you around.
Exactly. Bree, let's get ready to go, okay? We are 15 questions away from $1 million.
Yep.
You ready?
I'm ready.
Racing, let's go. $100 question. The term pearly whites is a common colloquialism for a person's what? A, nails, B, eyes, C, teeth, D, grey hairs.
Locking C, teeth, Eddie.
Locking teeth, it's correct for $100. Can I ask you, you got the tattoos on your chest there?
Yes.
What are they? What?
I had a fall, not my last fall, but I had another fall where I smashed my wrist pretty bad and my fingers were underneath my elbow and no one wanted me to ride again.
Yeah.
But I wasn't ready to give up, so I got risk everything, regret nothing.
There you go.
And went again.
And went again. Good stuff. Do you still ride?
Yeah.
$200. A common expression referring to the arrival of new information is hot off the what? A, press. B, plate. C, iron. D, coals.
That is hot off the press. A.
Lock it in for $200. Correct. Well done. Referring to the printing press of a newspaper, hot off the press, $300. It's the latest news. Which of these is a subtitle in the Fast and Furious film franchise? A, London Stack. B, Tokyo Drift. C, New York Burnout. D, Hollywood Bomb.
That is B, Tokyo Drift.
Tokyo Drift is in. Got your drift for $300, correct. Number three in the film franchise, released in 2006, The Fast and the Furious Tokyo Drift. $500, Brie. Historically used in the UK and Australia, the G in the acronym GPO stands for what post office? A, government. B, general. C, global. D, guarded.
I'm pretty sure I know this, but I'm going to pass.
Yeah?
Yes, I'm going to take a pass on this.
Okay, see you, Brett.
Thank you. Bye.
Hello, Holly.
Hello.
How are you? Good, thank you. Holly Peters is 25 years of age. You're a mortuary attendant.
I am.
Now, tell me about that. That must be a party starter when you start talking to people.
Yeah, it's two reactions.
Yeah.
They either love it or they, yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
It's a job that's always going to be there, isn't
exactly.
it?
Exactly. It's been very good to me.
Yeah. Forensic and scientific services. Mm-hmm. And you're into dentistry as well.
Yes, in my second year.
So when a body comes in, do you check the teeth out?
I have a little squiz.
Yeah.
Go check it out.
Yeah. So what do you actually do as a mortuary attendant?
So I assist the doctors in performing the autopsies. So, you know, all the dissection, the reconstruction, all the gruesome stuff.
Okay, but so you've got yourself in your head around being in the medical profession.
Exactly.
Going
yeah.
forward. Good on you, Holly. Well, someone's got to do it. There's no doubt about that.
Exactly.
So you're studying at Griffith University from Kangaroo Point in Queensland.
Mm-hmm.
Your partner is Andrew, who's a clothing brand owner. Which mm-hmm. one?
Livco, Don't Just Exist.
Yep. What are they? Tell me about Livco Don't Just Exist.
So it's a casual clothing brand. There are lots of hats and T-shirts. And he's from New Zealand, so he caters to the New Zealand market and that kind of stuff. He does hats for big heads.
Is that right?
Yes.
Hats for big heads. During Dental Health Week, you filmed yourself brushing your cat's teeth to enter a competition. As a result, you won an iPad and $1,000 worth of dentistry training.
Exactly.
How do you clean a cat's teeth?
Well, it wasn't toothpaste, it was tuna puree, but right. she enjoyed it, so...
Did she?
Yeah.
Should
she
cats have their teeth cleaned?
By a vet, not with toothbrushes and toothpaste.
All right, let's get stuck into it, Holly. Good luck. Historically used in the UK and Australia, the G in the acronym GPO stands for what post office? Government, General, Global, Guarded.
Don't actually know this one. I feel like it's General. Could be Government. Go B, General.
Lock in, General. It's correct for $500. Well done. Right, we're going to take a break. We're 11 off $1 million. We'll do it right after this in the hot seat. Questions to go for $1 million, six contestants, lifelines at the ready, everybody's in play. Holly Peters works as a mortuary attendant, also studying her dentistry. How long before you're a dentist?
Another 3 years.
3 years.
Mm-hmm.
Can I ask a question? Have you ever known anyone who's come in?
Come in?
Oh, mortuary.
Yes. Brisbane's a small place.
Yeah?
Yeah, definitely.
And that must be confronting.
Yeah, definitely. It's something to see someone in life and to death. It's not the same.
No.
So, yeah, my colleagues are really good and we all help each other, support each other.
Good on you, Holly. Well done. Right, $1,000. On a Windows computer, Control plus V is the keyboard's shortcut for which of these functions? A, copy. B, delete. C, paste. D, reboot.
It's going to be C, paste.
Lock it in?
Yes.
You know all this one? Yes. Incorrect. $1,000. Well played. $1,500. Which of these actors was jailed in 2019 in connection with a university admissions scandal? A. Terry Hatcher. B. Marcia Cross. C. Eva Longoria. D. Felicity Huffman.
I do know this one. It's Felicity Huffman, I'm pretty sure. She had her two daughters in the States. I'm going to go with D. Felicity Huffman.
Lock in D, Felicity Huffman. Yeah, it's correct for $1,500. Her husband, William H. Macy, didn't go in. Huffman was convicted of fraud and sentenced to 14 days in prison, fined $30,000, required to perform 250 hours of community service, and had a bit of talking to do to her daughters, that's for sure. $2,500. Car brand Land Rover is manufactured by a company called what Land Rover? A. Ferrari. B. Lamborghini. C. Jaguar. D. Porsche.
Oh, I'm not really into cars. I feel like it could be Porsche. I think I'm going to take my pass.
Catch you later, Holly.
Thank you.
See you later. Bye. Welcome, Simon. Simon Fallon is the man who just won $1,000 in Fastest Finger First. So you have got a lifeline, Simon. You've got $1,000 to keep if you want for your drone, or you can buy a plane for $1,000,000 if you like. Get the real thing.
Yeah, small one.
Simon is 56 from Hamilton in Queensland, corporate learning and development facilitator with Allianz Partners. Tell me what that means.
Basically, in-house corporate training, compliance training,
yep,
executive leadership development, that sort of stuff.
Stephanie's your wife, daughters Ashley, 29, Emily, 27. Three triplet children due on December 2020, which leads to why you're on the show tonight, and that is your family's recovering from a tragedy in recent times that I'm aware of. Matt Conwell is your son-in-law, who was tragically killed in a car accident.
Traffic. Hit by a car. While jogging. Yep.
While jogging. So he was out for a run. Well-known coach in cricket.
Yep.
And well-loved in the cricket world.
He
and a great man who was doing great things, which has left your daughter pregnant with triplets and a widow. Our thoughts are with you, Simon. In these times of tragedy and heartache and loss, there is nothing that we could say to make you feel better other than to give you a collective hug, mate, to you and your family. We're really feeling for you, mate.
Yep.
Good stuff. Now, let's reload.
Yep.
You won Sale of the Century. In fact, you were the third highest winner of Sale of the Century. $421,000. Wow. That's pretty good. But it's not $1,000,000 like we give you the chance to win, mate. What was it like then? Wow.
One, life-changing.
Yeah. What did you do with the dough?
A lot of it went into paying off the house at the time.
And who was hosting in those days?
Glenridge.
Ah, great. And who else was it? Karina Brown, yes.
Pete Smith was involved.
Of course, the great Pete Smith.
Absolutely.
What a great show it was. And Tony Barber and Glenridge, just two of the all-time great television hosts.
He was a really nice guy.
Yeah, fantastic guy, Glenn. Yeah. Hey, Simon, good luck, mate.
Thank you.
Let's hope you get another nice guy host of a show giving you a whole lot of money, OK?
That'd be awesome.
All right, $2,500. We've got nine to go to $1,000,000, buddy, and we're barracking for you. Car brand Land Rover is manufactured by a company called what Land Rover? Ferrari, Lamborghini, Jaguar, Porsche.
Well, one of the lines of business that Allianz Partners looks after is roadside assistance. And one of the partners that we've been with over those years has been Jaguar Land Rover, JLA, Jaguar Land Rover Australia. So lock in C, Jaguar.
Bang, it's in there. Jaguar Land Rover Australia, correct for $2,500. Owned for a little while by BMW and Ford, and these days Jaguar Land Rover is a subsidiary of the Indian automotive company Tata. Tata. Let's hope that I'm not saying Tata to you shortly. $4,000. The name of which of these food chains is incorrectly spelled? A. Gloria Jean's Coffees. B. The Coffee Club. C. Donut King. D. Krispy Kreme Donuts.
Into interesting. I'm playing on the words donut in these ones. Krispy Kreme. I think I might take a pass on this one, Eddie.
Okay, Simon.
Yeah.
Catch you later on, buddy.
Thank you.
Thank you. Don't be shy, don't be shy. Come on, jump into the hot seat. How are you feeling?
Oh, I'm ready.
You're ready?
Sort of.
I'm ready, sort
of. It's a tough crowd.
Alison Jack is a registered nurse at the Kawana Private Hospital. Where are you from in Queensland?
Mooloolaba.
From Mooloolaba.
Grew up in Brisbane.
Did you? Yeah.
Yep.
And now Mooloolaba.
Mooloolaba. Spent 25 years in Canada.
Was it the cold part of Canada?
Yes, Calgary.
Calgary is the really cold part of Canada.
Very. 40 right. below.
So how do you go from 40 below, or go from Queensland to 40 below, stay there for 20-odd years? You must have loved this bloke, Wayne.
Well, you know, you're young, silly.
Yeah. Why did it take so long to get him back over to sunny Queensland?
Well, he had to finish his career on the fire department. So Captain Jack, he'd had enough after 35 years. He could take early retirement, so was in the vows when he was done, back we come.
And back you come. Yeah. Adam and Eric, you're 25 and 22, they come with you?
They did.
Fantastic.
Yes.
How is the family enjoying Queensland?
Well, Sunshine Coast is nowhere better.
Pretty good place to be, isn't it? All right, Alison, let's go. The name of which of these food chains is incorrectly spelled? Gloria Jean's Coffees, The Coffee Club, Donut King, Krispy Kreme Donuts.
Oh, boy. Donut King, I think, is correct. The Coffee Club looks correct. Gloria Jean's Coffee. It's either A or D. Gloria Jean's Coffee.
A. Locked in. You think it's coffees, do you, or coffee?
Gloria Jean's Coffee.
Ah, it's Alison's Krispy Kreme Donuts. Krispy Kreme spells the donuts correctly. So Donut King, doing it sort of in the American way, and Krispy Kreme spelled their donuts D-O-U-G-H-N-U-T-S. Krispy Kreme Donuts. Alison, unfortunately, that's what you've received. Donuts.
Oh, well.
I'm sorry.
No worries.
See you, Alison. Good on you, Nick. Come and sit down, pal.
Thank you.
Warm up the seat because we're going to take a break and come back with more Hot Seat right after this. He's a senior investigator with Queensland Police. Nick Williams tells people that he works as an accountant in self-managed superannuation just to not have to talk about being on the job.
That's it. You know, because who asks questions about accountants?
Yeah,
you talk about compulsory superannuation, you talk about, concessional and non-concessional contributions, and everybody goes...
Is it just people ask inane questions, or you just want to leave the job behind and when you go out, you want to do something else?
Yeah, you always get those people that say, I got this traffic ticket once.
Oh, yeah, and, right, OK, you know. Yeah. Good on you, Nick. All right, let's go, buddy. You are 7 questions off $250,000. Here it is. Which of these animals makes a sound that is sometimes known as lowing? A, cat. B, dog. C, cow. D, horse.
Oh, I'm just trying to think of that nursery rhyme. What was the song? The Something's A-Lowing. I don't think it's a dog. I don't think it's a horse. I think it's a cat or a cow. I think I'm going to lock in C, cow.
Lock in C, cow. You're searching for a song. We're thinking of Away in the Manger.
Probably, yes.
Where the cattle are lowing.
Cattle are lowing, sounds
correct,
good.
For $4,000. Yeah. Yeah, the cattle are lowing, the baby awakes. A low is another term, really, for a moo. Mm. No one.
That's good, Eddie.
Yeah, 6,000. Who won the Women's Singles Championship at the 2020 Australian Open? A, Ashley Barty. B, Simona Halep. C, Garbiñe Muguruza. or D, Sophia Kennan?
I have no idea. I'm leaning towards Ash Barty. Not sure if she actually won it though.
2020 Australian Open.
The other ones I don't really know. You know, I probably won't get back, but I'm going to pass, I think, Eddie.
Catch you later, Nick. See you, buddy. Good on you, Adam. Welcome, buddy. Adam Spees is from the Gold Coast.
Local, yeah. Born and bred.
That's it. 33 years of age. Davo's Crane High. You're an operations manager?
Yeah. Davo's, get it up. That's our slogan.
Is that right?
Getting up for the coast.
How big are the cranes?
We've got 13 mobile cranes. So it range from our smallest of 12-ton city crane, and we go up to 100-ton cranes, so we can get most things up.
Now, Adam, having heard you speak, mate, and get them up cranes, doesn't quite surprise me that your first date with your now wife, Ash, was you took her to see the Brisbane Broncos play and a pizza at the pub afterwards.
Yeah, yeah.
You old romantic,
you. It worked a treat because she's a member now, so that worked well, yeah.
Yeah, and you want to have kids because you want to be a sports coach.
Yeah, I don't care what sport. I love all sports, so... Yeah, I'd coach anything, just want to be a coach. So start popping some kids out and see how we go.
Good stuff. Now, tell me about this. You went to Whistler in Canada and you're working there, what do you, as a manager in the grocery store, and you saw this bloke hitting everybody with snowballs.
Yeah.
Right in the head, couldn't miss.
Yeah, where we were is right in the village square. I think you've been to Whistler, have you, Eddie? I don't know.
No, I haven't. No.
Well, anyway, then right in this village square there is where everyone hangs out, and our grocery store's right there. And just wrapping some cheese up on the bench and saw this guy throwing snowballs at all these kids and bang, straight in the head every single time. Jeez, he's a good shot. And obviously wearing a beanie and the rest of it, can't tell who it was. And then when he came in the store, took his beanie, oh, jeez, that's the pigeon.
The pigeon.
Glenn McGrath.
Glenn McGrath.
No wonder he hit him.
How are the kids going?
Middle stump every time.
Ducking and weaving all over the place.
It's pretty good.
The big pigeon. Glenn McGrath, the great cricketer. Good stuff. All right, let's go. Who won the Women's Singles Championship at the 2020 Australian Open? Was it Ash Barty? Was it Simona Halep? Was it Garbiñe Muguruza or Sophia Kennan?
Look, Eddie, I'm pretty sure it's not Ash Barty. I think she got knocked out. I'm leaning towards Simona Halep or D. I don't really know who C is. I'm just going to have to take a stab, and I think B. Lock in B, Simona Halep. Or D, maybe. Look, I'll go D.
Lock 5 seconds. What are you going for?
I'll go C.
Which one?
B.
No, Sophia Kennan won. First Grand Slam win, the US player at 21 years of age became the tournament's youngest singles champion since Maria Sharapova back in 2008. Barty and Halep were knocked out in the semis, and Muguruza was beaten by Kennan in the final. Sorry, Adam.
All good.
Ah, it's not good, mate. It's no good.
Thanks anyway.
Good on you, buddy.
Thanks, Eddie.
Wish you all the best. Thanks, mate. Come on, Bree. Bree Squires has had a huge night already. 12 correct answers. They have in the Fast Finger First. Mm-hmm. Two already being up here in the hot seat. So 14 correct answers. You're on fire. Be confident, okay? We're 5 questions away from $100,000 and Bree's in the saddle, ready to go. And hopefully she wins after this. Ready to go in the hot seat. The first person to ride the fabulous Maccabi Diva. Let's go. $6,000 question. Bree, here it is. Big mistake, big, huge is a famous line from which Julia Roberts movie? A, Erin Brockovich. B, Notting Hill. C, Pretty Woman. D, My Best Friend's Wedding.
I've actually seen all of these movies and I love Julia Roberts. So I do know that that line is from Pretty Woman, C.
Lock it in. What was the scene?
She was in a store on Rodeo Drive and the snobby chicks wouldn't serve her and she came back later with the money.
Big mistake, big, huge, correct, Pretty Woman, $6,000. Four to go, 4 contestants, everyone in play. Nick can win $10,000. Simon, $20,000, $50 for Holly, and for you, Bree, You can win $1,000 or $100,000. Here it comes. In Italian cuisine, agrodolce is a type of what? A, bread. B, cheese. C, wine. D, sauce.
I don't actually know this. Dolce is making me think of grapes, wine. I'm going to lock in C, wine.
Final answer?
Yep.
In. Sauce is correct. It's a sweet and sour sauce traditionally made from a base of vinegar and sugar. Bree, that's where it ends. Good luck with everything.
Thank you,
Bree. See ya. Come on, Holly. Mortuary attendant, dentist. Geez, you picked out a couple of good jobs there, haven't you, really?
I'm working my way up, yeah.
Well, you got one where there's no complaints and one where there's always complaints, isn't there,
really?
Yeah,
it's going to be an adjustment.
Exactly. All right, let's go. $10,000. Good luck, Holly. Tashkent is the capital of which country? A, Cambodia. B, Uzbekistan. C, Mongolia. D, India.
Thinking maybe B? I don't think it's India or Cambodia. Tashkent. Mongolia. I was trying to brush up on my capitals, but
you forgot to do
didn't
it.
Stick this one, obviously.
Okay. Six.
I'm going to go with B.
Uzbekistan, locked in, correct for $10,000. Population of around 2.5 million people, by the way. A largest city in Central Asia, situated at the eastern arm of the country near the Kazakhstan border. I think that's you done, Nick, unfortunately, but thanks for being a part of the show, buddy.
Thank you.
And good luck and continued great work with Queensland Police.
Thanks, mate.
Simon, you're a chance to win $20,000. Holly, get this right, I'll give you a grand, and you can win $50,000 cash. Here we go. Which of these modern-day currencies has holes in two of its circulating coins? A, Japanese yen. B, Chinese yuan. C, euro. D, Hong Kong dollar.
Oh, there's holes in two of its circulating. I have held a few of these and I've only been to Japan out of those.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think Europe has it. Could it be Chinese yuan? Two of its circulating coins. I feel like it could be the Chinese coins. I feel like I've seen people wearing them as necklaces with the hole in the middle.
10 seconds.
It's the euro.
Five. Come on.
B.
B?
Yeah.
You've been to Japan?
Yeah. Didn't handle a lot of coins though.
No, clearly not. No, it's the Japanese. In the centre of both, it's 5 and 50 yen coins. The holes make the coins more easily distinguishable by touch and sight. Holly, you missed by one. Thanks for being part of the show.
Good luck
with everything, OK?
Thank you.
See you later. Bye. Come on, Simon. Good on you, Simon. A man who has cleaned up on Channel 9 quiz shows before, winning $421,000 on Sale of the Century back in the day. Mate, we mentioned earlier that the family's gone through a tragic period where you lost your son-in-law, Matt Conwell. Was out for a jog and was run over as he was having a run and has left your daughter, Ashley, who's 29, who is pregnant and having triplets in December 2020 as a single mum, now a widow. We just wrap our arms around you and your family.
Thanks, Eddie.
Let's hope you win the $20,000. You've got a lifeline.
Yep.
You've got another $1,000. We're going to take a news break, and when we come back, we want to put $20,000 in your pocket.
On 9 News at 5, no one to blame for the Power Family COVID exemption bungle. Concerns up to 60,000 gel blasters are in SA. And why local drivers will continue to pay too much for petrol. Live from Adelaide, next.
Simon Fallon has a big, deep breath. All right, buddy. Have another big one, okay?
Oh, yeah.
Lots this means a bit for the family, doesn't it?
It does.
Yeah, yep. Let's have a change of fortunes in what has been a horrible, horrible year, mate. Okay. Mm. Good luck. For $20,000, Simon, here we go. In total, how many English kings have been crowned George? A4, B6, C8, D10.
Okay. I'm pretty sure I know this one, but I also want to narrow my odds as much as I possibly can.
Okay, you've got 30 seconds, yeah. So just let's have a think. What are you thinking at the moment?
I'm thinking George the Sixth pops into my mind as one of the latest ones. So I'm taking out 8 and 10. And before that timer runs out, I think I'm going to make sure of things.
What are you going to do? What lifeline are you going to use?
I'm going to go 50-50. Actually, I might ask the host. No, lock it in, 6.
What do you want to put me under the hammer for?
Couldn't blame myself. Because you're a man of the world and you're very knowledgeable.
Well, if there's any consolation, we're both going down together.
Right.
Because I would have gone George the Sixth.
Yeah.
Simon, let's hope that this horrible year for you and your family has ended right now. You've won $20,000. Well done, buddy. Well done. I can't even think what you're thinking and what Ashley and Emily and Stephanie, your wife, are thinking, and the family of Matt. I'm emotional just sitting here, mate.
It'll make a big difference.
Good on you.
Really will.
And I'm glad you didn't take that $1,000 because that means you've won $21,000. Congratulations, Simon Fallon. Just won $21,000. See you next time in the Millionaire Hot Seat. Good night. Well done, buddy.